What if I told you that creating stunning AI art doesn't require complex prompts or technical knowledge? Today, I'm going to show you how CGDream is revolutionizing AI image generation, and the best part, you can generate images for free. CGDream isn't just another image generator either. Let me show you what makes it special. Want to create art with the exact pose that you're imagining? CGDream can copy the structure from any reference image while keeping the desired style and character. Need your character to maintain a consistent look across different scenes? CGDream's character reference system lets you do exactly that. And here's something that's really unique. CGDream can convert any image into a 3D model, letting you change the camera angle and create an entirely new perspective. In the next few minutes, I'll show you how to use all these features, even with a free plan. No complex prompts needed, just your imagination. To get started, go to cgdream.ai. With a free tier, you do get 3,000 monthly credits and access to models like Juggernaut and FLUX. But of course, if you enjoy this platform, then I highly recommend upgrading to one of the paid plans. Now back to the homepage, click on Start Generating for Free to create your account. This is the gallery page. This is a great way to view the creations by other users and to get inspiration for your own images. We can filter on different types of images. For instance, we can show images that were generated by text prompts, images that were generated from images, or images that were generated by 3D models. We can also filter on rising images, new images, as well as the best images. We can also search for images by entering any keyword. And as an example, we can search for dogs, and this will bring up all images containing dogs. When we click on any image, we can see the exact prompt that was used to generate the image. And on the left-hand side, we can see any styles or structures that were used. Or if we scroll down, and usually on your screen, everything should be in view. But for this tutorial, I've zoomed in a bit just to make things a bit more visible. But on the left-hand side, you can see all the filters that were applied to create this effect. And we will have a look at filters in this video as well. On the right-hand side, we can view other settings like the aspect ratio, the model that was used, and the quality and speed option. We are able to zoom in and out of an image to view the finer detail, or simply double-click on an image to zoom in all the way. We can also favorite an image by clicking on this heart button, and we can view all of the images that we favorited by going to favorites, and we can see our favorite images over here. So let's click on this image again, and if we want to generate an image that is similar to this, we can make any changes to this prompt or add our own filters. And once we've done that, we can simply click on generate. We can see that our image is currently being generated, and we can click on this icon to view the generation progress. And after a few seconds, we get this image back, which I think looks great. We can view all of our generations at any time by clicking on My Images. And for now, we only have this one image. So let's go ahead and generate more images. We can generate images from anywhere in the application by entering our prompt in this input box at the bottom of the screen. I'm simply going to clear this out, and on the left-hand side, I'm also going to remove all of these filters. So let's enter a prompt like an Amazonian warrior with a sword and a lion in background. The strength about CGDream is that you do not have to enter complex prompts. The short prompt will be sufficient to get a very good result. On the right hand side, we can change the aspect ratio. I'm actually going to change it to 1:1. We can also set the amount of variance. I'll change it to 2, but if you are on a paid plan, you can change this to 3 or even 4 variants. We can use the prompt guide to tell CGDream how closely it needs to stick to our prompt. I'll just leave it in the middle. For the model, we can select between Juggernaut or Flux. I'll simply leave it on Flux, but for the quality, I'm going to change it to the quality option, and let's click on generate. We were able to achieve these results with a very simplistic prompt. We can greatly improve the results by using filters. We can access filters in one of two ways. While focusing on the input box, we can simply press enter, or we could also simply click on filters over here. CGDream will now automatically bring up a whole bunch of filters that is relevant to our prompt. However, we can also search for other filters as well. For this prompt, let's select Barbarian. I'll also select Melee Weapons and perhaps Battle Fantasy. We can see those filters being applied on the left-hand side over here. And for each of these filters, we can adjust the strength of that filter, which will adjust the impact of that filter on the final image. Once you've selected your filters, you can change any of these settings or simply generate a single image just to save on credits and click on Generate. I don't know about you, but this looks way better than the previous results. CGDream provides a powerful feature that can assist you in writing complex prompts. Let's have a look at DreamUp. You will notice next to this Generate button, you can see this button called DreamUp. DreamUp will use AI to take your prompt to the next level. Let's click on this button and let's wait for our image to be generated. And if we open this up, we can see the entire prompt that was added by DreamUp. Of course, if we wanted to keep our female character, we could simply go back to our gallery. Let's click on this one and let's add female Amazonian warrior. Let's click on DreamUp. And let's wait for this result. Let's click on this image and we can hover over this input box to see the full prompt. This is awesome. And this looks super real as well. We can greatly enhance the details of the image using upscaling. To upscale an image, simply click on this x2 button and wait for the image to generate. When we zoom into this image, we can see that a lot more detail was indeed added, and we can view the differences between this image and the original by clicking on this x2 button again. We can also transfer the styles from any image to our generation. As an example, let's grab this image. I'm then going to download it, and let's actually create a new image. So I'm going to delete all of their references as well as their filters, just so that we can start from scratch. I'm also going to remove this prompt. And let's enter a brand new prompt. And I'm actually going to enter something that's not related to this reference image at all, like a man in business attire. Now, let's say that we wanted to generate this image using the styles from this image. All we have to do is go to Styles. Now let's upload any image. So of course I'll upload this image as the style reference. When we hover over this, we can also select the strength of the style. I'll just leave it on 1. And let's click on Generate. Now do take note that this does not mean that our prompt will be changed to a woman. It will simply transfer the styles of this image to our prompt. Let's have a look at the result. And yes, we get a man in business attire, which is pulling the style from our reference image. We can also transfer a pose or structure from a reference image. Let me show you how that works. I'm going to clear this style. Let's go back to the gallery and let's look for a very dramatic looking pose. And I think this image will work very well. I'm going to download this as my reference image. Then I'm going to clear this prompt. Let's enter our prompt again of a man in business attire. And this time, let's upload this image as a structure reference. I'll leave the strength on the default value. And I'm going to generate this image using DreamUp. But of course, you can just run the normal generation as well. And now we get our brand new image that uses the same structure as the reference. We can also generate new images using a consistent character. So what we can do is download this image so that we can use it as a reference going forward. So I'm going to clear the structure reference. We don't have any folders applied. Now, what we can do is upload a character reference. So let's select this princess reference image. And in the prompt, we can enter something like a cinematic fight scene of a woman exhausted and bruised after a brawl. Let's add a few filters to this as well by pressing enter. I'm going to search for a filter called fight scene. So I'll select this. Let's also search for something called woman realistic. So I'll select this one. And maybe to make it a bit more dramatic, let's search for rain. So we can add this one. Cool. Let's go ahead and generate this. And this gives us a way more dramatic image. And this is very clearly based on that Elsa character. We can also generate images using 3D models. Either you can upload your own model or we can click on 3D models to view a library within CGDream with a whole bunch of 3D models. For instance, let's use this carnival ride. So when we click on it, We can view this 3D model and change its perspective. Then we can enter any prompt that we want using this 3D model as reference. So I'll enter something like a carnival Ferris wheel and rides in a post-apocalyptic world. I'm actually going to zoom into this as well using my mouse wheel. Then for the filters, let's add dystopian apocalyptic. Let's also search for rusty and perhaps industrial abandoned. Let's generate this. And this looks incredible. CGDream allows us to generate 3D models from our generated images, and we can then change the perspective in the model to generate an entirely new image. For this, I'm going to generate a simple image, something like a cup of coffee on a white background. And this is a very interesting generation because I forgot to remove the filters. So let's remove these. And in fact, why not? Let's keep this. And what we can do now is generate a 3D model from this image by clicking on this Convert to 3D Model button. This will give us this crude 3D render. But don't worry about the detail of this render, because all we really want is to slightly change the perspective so that we can generate a brand new image. I'm actually going to remove the white background this time, and let's add in a cyberpunk coffee shop. Let's add a few filters like cyberpunk, and let's generate this image. And now we can see our cup of coffee in a very different environment and from a very interesting perspective. I really appreciate the control that CGDream gives us to generate any artwork that we can imagine. I think this is an incredible platform, and I highly recommend you give it a try yourself. Please let me know in the comments below if you would like me to cover more videos on CGDream or similar image generation software. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.